Excitement in the kitchen. Say, let's see the excitement.
All right. Just you come along with me and I'll show it to you.
Welcome, I am Jonathan, otherwise known as Senor Smoke, here at Curto's in Westchester County. I want to welcome you to the sanctum of informed appliance and grill, outdoor kitchen knowledge. It's all here. We are the place. We deliver the goods, we deliver the knowledge, and we deliver the right prices. Thank you very much. So today, a little bit of a different angle on the video. Instead of extolling the virtues of a particular feature or a function of Alfresco, that's what we're going to talk about today. What else is new? I'm going to talk to you about, I'm going to give you some safety tips, okay? Because I'm going to reflect on two incidents that I had where I nearly blew the Alfresco grill clear to Kingdom Come, and because of said grill's proximity to my house, which was built in 1922 and has a lot of wood in it, shit could have gone up, okay? And all I'm gonna say is thank God everything was okay. Thank God my wife wasn't home with the kids, because if she saw the inferno that I created with this grill, she would have had my ass, okay? The two incidents I wanna talk to you about where I nearly blew the grill up is, one was related to the solid fuel insert and one was related to the rotisserie. So let's do the rotisserie first. It's pretty straightforward. My number one tip when using the rotisserie, and we could use this again for the Alfresco or any, whether you have a Lynx, a DCS, any of these grills that are outfitted with the rotis, the number one rule, and this is going to be so basic, you need to truss the food appropriately, okay? So notice, the tip has really nothing to do with the grill. It has to do with the way that you prepare, all right? So in this one instance that I'm talking about, I was going to smoke tiss a chicken, okay? And the problem was twofold. Number one, I did not truss the bird correctly. So after a few rotations on the spit, all right, the legs flapped out, all right? Well, actually, legs don't flap, wings flap. The legs fell out, and that led to the problem that I'm going to get to. So I didn't do the right, there's a butcher's, there's a certain truss method. Is it French? Is it the French knot? I don't know. I picked it up off Steve Reichlin's, off one of his books. I didn't do it correctly. The legs fell out. That created a problem because as the bird is turning, okay, and the chicken's starting to fall out of the web that you've created for it, it's going to drag. It's going to hit the grate or the drip pan that's underneath it, okay? And it's gonna create resistance. The spit's not gonna be able to turn, all right? And when the spit can't turn, the fats and the juices are just rolling off and now they're gonna hit the grill. And that's gonna cause a problem. It's gonna hit the burner and things are gonna go up. The second problem that occurred in this particular cook was that not only was the bird not trussed correctly, I did not set the prongs in securely enough as well. So not only did the leg fall out of the truss, the prongs got loose, the rotisserie spit prongs. That created a problem as well. So what happened, the bird started to just basically getting done, right? And I don't care how strong the motor is, and the motor on the rotisserie on the Alfresco is a beast. It's not gonna be able to turn appropriately if the food's falling off the spit. And here's the other mistake I made. I left it alone. I went inside, I had a beer, whatever it was, some other cold libation, probably several. Went inside, and I was inside for about 15 minutes. When I came back out, all right, and in these 15 minutes, the bird stopped turning, all right? And then shit was just getting undone. It was going sideways big time. And I came out, and there's literally flames pouring out of the back of the Alfresco, out of the back of the hood, because there's a little bit of separation between the top of the canopy and the back for air. Well, it was spitting fire like Godzilla, all right? So I run over, I go, holy shit! I go, it's gonna blow. So I realize, I said, I'm gonna sacrifice myself over here. I gotta get to the gas to shut it off. I'm using an LP tank, right? And I realized there was no way I was going to open the door of the cart and be able to get in there and unscrew the turn the gas off, because it was coming out so fast and furious. All right, I don't know what kind of time that I was working with over here, and I was just preparing for the thing to blow. So I'm going in sideways. I'm saying, if it's gonna blow, you know, it'll scar my back and my arm or something like that. I gotta preserve my face, please. I don't have much hair left, so I have to preserve the features. So I'm going in sideways. I realize there's no way I'm gonna do this. So what I did was, I just went to the knob. I went to the knob and I shut the gas off for the rotisserie burner, and for the burner that was in the middle position under the grate, because I had heat coming up from there as well. I got them to shut off. Now that didn't shut the fire down. Of course, the fire is still going. Once I saw that I had the gas off, I got a little braver, and I did go in and turn the gas off on the tank, and fortunately, nothing blew up. So suffice to say, I had some scorched marks in the back on my fence. I mean, this thing really, if I had been inside longer, I don't want to even think about what could have happened.